SME Market Hub. Buy, sell, list, connect.
Hello and welcome to Real Talk. I'm Cornelia O'Dwyer and we are at 355 Restaurant on Okoawo in Victoria Island. I'm about to meet up with some friends for some drinks and some chick chat, so join me.
On Real Talk today, we have Obi Somto, Nigeria's well-renowned photographer, Mercy Ajisafe, on-air personality at Cool FM, and Jorah Olomofin, aka Dr. Muffin, the social psychologist.
Hello, guys.
Look at you.
You're going to make me hug everybody?
I'll make you hug two times if that works for you. I want another one.
Okay.
But I wanted another one.
You look lovely.
Thank you. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having us. Welcome to Real Talk.
Yeah, how you doing?
So should we dive straight into it?
Okay, yeah. Might as well. Let's go.
Okay, so I'll start with this. Somebody said to me recently that basically I was jonesing if I thought I could abstain from sex and get married. And by that they mean like anytime soon. I thought, so that means if I have any chance, it means you can't lock up the cookie jar. You have to test the goods. So I guess I'll throw it to you first. How high? Because on my list it doesn't really rank as priority. So how high
is sex
on your list for you?
For me, it is extremely important. It's very, very high on the list. I have to be so honest.
In terms of the goodness of it,
frequency, everything.
Okay.
No. I'm just being honest. No, it's true. It's very, very important. Very important.
So we should get married.
I would just tell you the houseboy.
That's fine, baby.
So is this something that you discussed in prior to? Because I mean, I guess if you have a relationship.
Yes.
People talk about finances, so who starts the topic? Do you start it?
Well, do you know what, it's difficult, because when you start speaking about abstinence in a relationship, first of all, I think it's one of those things that it's a very personal decision. You know, it's unique to everyone. Everyone has their own level of, you know, comfort. Yeah. And for me personally, I knew before I was even active that I didn't think I would be abstaining, because it's something, it's a gift that we've been given. It's very beautiful. People say that, oh, you know, it's just for marriage couples. Mm-hmm, but at the same time, am I sure? Well, you see, my belief system is very different.
She's the one.
I think that a lot of our behavior as human beings, as adults, is learned. You got your religion from your parents. They most likely got their religion from their parents. True. And the thing is that a lot of the times, the reason why people abstain from sex is because of their religion. So my belief system is very different. So I don't have that.
I think it's culture based, you know.
Especially in Nigeria. Yeah. Definitely culture based.
But that is also connected to the
religion.
Fact that we are also
religious.
Religious.
Super religious.
Actually ties
everything,
to that.
Yeah. There you go.
So let me throw it to you. Do you dispute that? Do you think that a relationship can survive?
I don't think so. I think it's like a lifestyle.
Okay.
If you're a guy and you've been having sex for a very, very long time and you meet it like a girl, like it's been very hard for you not to have sex.
I mean, personally, don't you feel that if people were to abstain more, there would be, you get to know the person more. You kind of feel like, maybe I don't really like you. So what is your extension period? So if you were to abstain, so you don't believe in abstinence.
No, I don't know.
So any ladies, I don't know what the camera is.
I think sex is passion.
Ladies, he is not having that. He's testing the goods.
Sorry.
Do you believe in abstinence?
Baby girl, calm down. I'll be back to that question. When you were talking to him earlier, you said that abstinence will enable you know the person more.
Yes.
I totally disagree.
Okay.
Because if you're with someone and you're not having sex with that person, you most likely will be looking forward to having sex with that person.
Like there's no fire. Yes.
It'll cloud your judgment.
What, the fact that you can't?
Not the fact that you can't. The fact that you haven't.
Okay.
And instead of thinking, I'm with this person, this is this person, you probably be thinking, I'm with this person, when am I going to have sex with this person?
So you want to do it and get it over with.
He's saying that, you know, the anticipation of it happening and coming will kind of cloud your judgment. But what
she's
saying is very real. I believe the thing is that lust can be quite dangerous. It clouds your judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's very, very seductive. And the thing is,
I think it's a mindset, basically.
Because of lust.
It's a mindset.
Your mindset is stuck on having it. Your mindset is like,
you know, if you're not having sex, there's no passion. Like, you're not experiencing passion with that person.
I agree, but
you guys can have sex, but like you can decide not to have sex like 6 months before your wedding or like a year, but like you meet a girl and you guys are just talking, like, what's the difference between her and like a regular girl?
So if you have it and it's bad, what do? You walk away? You definitely want to have it.
You see our parents, most of them that waited,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Most of them are waited before testing the goods and then marriage. That's why we have all the problems we have today.
How is that?
It's like when you meet someone and you want to have sex with them, like you have a crush on them, they're like, oh my god, I want to be with this person, I want to have sex with this person, yada 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 yada, and that drives you.
Yes, okay.
But is that what I'm saying to you? Are you saying, because you guys see it as
calm down, baby girl, I'm coming.
You haven't gotten there yet. I'm basically
totally gonna land.
I mean, do you want me to be a 1 minute man?
Well, it seems like you're quite comfortable with that. So
No. I mean, you haven't had sex with this person, so there's something that's driving you. Mm-hmm. And then once you have sex with this person, you're like, oh, so that was it, and you move on. But then if you are with that person, you have sex with that person, and you're like, that was nice. There's more to this person. Don't you think?
What if it wasn't nice? What if you felt That's a good thing.
You...
I feel like a lot of... Let me just say, Lagos guys nowadays talk a good game.
They talk a good game.
And I found, and this is what I've heard from many people...
Oh, this is what you've heard. I mean, not what you've experienced. Yes, what you've heard.
Well, a little bit of what I've experienced. Okay. But I just find that they talk a good game, but then behind closed doors... Like,
they don't come through. They don't follow through.
Like, you know, so I feel like I'm not wasting my count, because there's the body count thing. I'm not wasting my count on you if... You are going to talk a good game and then be fall flat.
You know,
so I'm disappointed, and I liked you before. So it would have been better if I didn't. We got married. I'm already
sorry.
Late.
Just so we're clear, we're not talking about me.
Not you personally.
Yeah. Okay.
I wrote an article recently about our generation on appreciating like virgins and ladies who don't have sex anymore.
I remember.
It's kind of true. You know, like most guys nowadays, if a girl is not having sex, like they don't want to have it. Like they want to have sex with the girl to know if she's good, she's not good, so they'll know if they'll proceed
or not.
You know, like if you ask a guy to introduce you to a girl and you say she's a virgin, they'll be like, nah, she's long, things like that. So it's
I don't think you speak for all guys, but I think you guys are unique, because I think there are some guys that wait to talk.
No, definitely, there are lots of guys who wait.
They're different people, different
needs.
It's
worse on our side because there's no size.
Some guys are paranoid. Like she can tell you that she's not having sex with you. And she's gonna have sex with someone else.
Vice versa.
Now here's the thing. I don't think abstinence is wrong or bad. I think it's a beautiful thing. If that's a decision you've made for yourself and that's what works for you and your partner, well, most especially you, because it's about you, then that's wonderful.
What's as long for you?
Seven months.
That's much longer than that. Cred.
Yeah,
I know, much longer than I thought.
You just touched up.
He's not gonna last 2 weeks.
He won't last
2 weeks. what's your threshold?
You need to define abstinence first.
Oh Jesus.
So abstinence meaning no sexual activity, so no nookie and no fondling. So I'm sure you could kiss without feeling aroused. Whatever's needed to get aroused, you need to stop. So abstinence means
no kissing, no nothing then.
No masturbation, no oral sex, nothing. Wow. Just literally you and your girlfriend are going to...
The movies.
Not even because it's a picnic.
Shosh.
You're just going out on cultural and fun experiences.
Money, that one is hard to...
I can do it if we've
had... So you haven't answered how long?
I can do it if we've had sex already.
So you know what you're getting.
Yes.
So you know what you're getting.
In no way, I know she's good. And I'm going to stop and respect her when she's ready again.
So that's good. What is your idea of good?
It's good sex when she makes an impression. Okay. If you have sex with your girl and you've forgotten in 2 days and she didn't do a good job.
Oh, wow.
So why is it on her, though? Like, that, see what I'm saying? Like, so what is good sex for you? I'll come back to that.
Glasses are turned on for me. Ooh, okay. If you have glasses, you got me.
So you like the school teacher thing?
Role play,
yeah.
Do you know what
I find really amusing about this? Because it's quite funny, because the whole thing about abstinence, we always get guys saying, oh no, man, if you do, I'm all right, you should gotta give me. But the thing about it, I personally feel like it's more important. Men can abstain, because at the end of the day, you can drive any vehicle, and it will drive and get you from A to B. You guys will get to B. For women, it's very different. You're talking about, oh, she got to be good. It has to be memorable. You know what? Eight out of ten guys.
Wait, a Nigerian man can abstain.
Just
like
I don't even think we should even go down to Nigerian men. I think men in general
have that same issue. And why I find it really funny is because you guys are talking about, you know, well, you know, we have to try to make sure she's good. When 8 out of 10 times, you guys are the ones who really don't know what you lot are doing.
And
if you understand what I mean, that's the truth.
What if you get married to this person and you guys are not compatible sexually?
I think that men are naturally okay with having it more than women. I think women need to before, but at the point where I'm getting married to you, I'm already okay having sex with you. I think women process that differently from the way men process it. If I'm getting married to you, best believe that I have in my head gone through a couple of things that make you okay to sleep with. Like, I don't know that.
Sorry, I can't marry you if you're not amazing in bed. I will cheat on you
with
the house.
Your assumption, yeah.
What
assumption? Yes. When you're getting married to someone, you're okay with having sex with that person. Does this apply?
No, I said I'm okay not.
She doesn't need to.
I'm okay not having sex.
So you are going to marry somebody that you've not.
I mean, it's sad because I'm not going to pretend and status. It's sad that I now know what is.
That's not realistic.
I find it to be very acrobatic. I find it to be a little boom, 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 and bam, 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 and that's it. I don't necessarily need to be orgasmic all the time. It is not a priority for me.
It is biologically necessary.
It is, seriously. But as for me, if you're not amazing in bed, I will cheat on you with the houseboy.
It is
biologically necessary.
I said I'm okay not
You're okay not having sex mentality lead you to marry a brother with a little PP,
uh-huh.
And you get into the wedding and realize that the brother has a little PP.
That's okay. So I
Of course you do. Yeah. I love you too.
The other things,
the love will disappear.
Okay, but like, what do you think is the lifespan of the abstinence? The lifespan, like,
I could go years.
Oh wow.
Do you understand? I could go years.
Oh wow, this is good.
I have gone years. Okay, so like, I don't think it's not top priority for me. I don't like. No, we can go to separate countries. Like, I can live in any country with my husband. I can up and leave. So if we have to do long distance for a while, it's not something that would affect, at least me, on my side of things. It might affect him because he's a man, but I can hold my own.
No, but the operative word is said me.
I'm less likely to cheat on him because, like I said, it's not going to be grabs that is going to make me go and knock on your door.
As for me, I would rather not live in a separate country from my husband. I don't believe in long distance.
So you're strong on intimacy then?
Big intimacy is the most. First of all, with friendship, you have to be my best friend. Literally, you have to be my buddy. It's like, you literally have to be my
Really? No, you have to be my best friend. I have to
tell you
everything. You have to be the one.
I don't think my husband has to be my best friend.
No, do you know, it's just the kind of person I am. Because
my best friend.
We decided to take Real Talk to the streets.
Do I think sexual abstinence is possible? I would say yes, because I have tried it. But I'm sexually active at the same time, so I can switch it on and off. So there are times I'm like, okay, yeah, I think I want to abstain. I just don't want any guy to touch me. Ew.
I like sex, too, and I cannot stay with that woman. If I go find where I go, the chat, put chat up.
Having tasted from the apple tree, it's quite difficult to run away from it. Sex depends on the female. If the woman says no, there's nothing you can do about it.
I do. Professional sex. So as a man, so no one, anywhere, any angle, I'm with you. So I'm very, very happy.
I believe that you should abstain from sex until you're properly married because it protects you from unnecessary stress.
I don't think I can do without sex for up to a year. If I cannot do without sex for up to a year, I think the same goes to every man. For women, they can't do without sex for 6 months.
Sexual abstinence is just the best up until when they are 21.
I don't think it's right for either parties to abstain from sex for no reason. You don't have to be selfish to your partner.
Ladies now, everybody wants to cash one and doing big girls. They waste man 6 months plus now. I don't meet woman. If he catch me, I enter my bedroom, I watch my blue film, I masturbate. And the doctor said masturbation doesn't help. It helps.
If I don't see anybody, I go use vaccine, I will charge myself. I don't date before 6 years. I don't meet woman. Now this last month, now just after 5 months. Now my girlfriend, I join with. But I get wife.
Thank you guys for joining us. It was a great conversation. I didn't expect you to put me on the spot. Thank you. I just really can't believe that you didn't speak for us sisters and like, you know, hold us up.
Well,
like,
you know what the truth is? I would have been a liar if I did that. I had to be.
And we love you for being honest, darling.
She's real.
Thank you for being honest. I think a lot of guys need to wait that 6 months. Well, you can join the conversation by using the hashtag #AndaniRealTalk. If you have a story or a topic you would like us to discuss, follow us at AndaniTV and use the hashtag #AndaniRealTalk. Thank you guys for joining us once again.
Thank you for having us.
What when your girlfriend is traveling, you're supposed to give her some money.
Yes, now. As an allowance now.
You can't give her an allowance.
Honestly, that thing disgusts me.
What?
Honestly, what's going on? What do you mean by this? My girlfriend is traveling. So,
so what are you supposed to do? Even when you are working, if you leave allowance.
And you see, that is the problem.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my name is Files, aka Files the Bad Guy. Well, in today's lesson, I will teach you how to subscribe to the Indani TV channel. All you have to do is click on this. So simple, straightforward.